this is Abhiram.
And this is D.C. Amishir.
We are from Vishnu School, Bhimavaram.
We are staying in campus right now. This is a project, cyclone detector. First of all, when cyclone occurs, meteorology departments show scrolling on the TV screen and they may alert the people, mail services, calls, etc. And these all. So for this process, they use a high technology which is very expensive. So in this project, we are going to show that apart from satellites, we can use windmills for detection of cyclones. You may raise a question that how can we detect cyclone by windmills? So for, assume this as a region. So this is the boundary of the region. Each and every region at least has one windmill or one or two. So it may be here water windmill, irrespective of a place. We will place windmills near the boundary of this region, not in this region. Around the boundary, when we place windmills, when cyclone enters this region of this area, so its wind speed is really very high, nearly 300 km per hour. So this makes windmills to rotate at the same speed, which is almost equivalent to 300 km per hour. So assume this as a cyclone and this is our windmill.
This is artificial cyclone creator. So for example, we made a project that will detect cyclone debris. So if we want to test it, we have to wait until the cyclone comes. So cyclone comes at the wind comes at a speed of 300 km per hour. So we are creating a air with that same speed.
So when cyclone rotates at 300 km per hour, the windmill rotates which is equivalent to the speed of it. So by this we can get a brief idea that cyclone is going to strike this region. So when we got information that it will strike this region, so what we will do? Inform the people, right? So informing and as I said earlier, making alerts and sirens, this takes a lot of time, which is a very complicated process and very time consuming. So using a GSM module, we will make this very faster telecommunication, right? So GSM stands for the Global System Monitoring. Using SIM and radio waves, we can transmit information within fraction of seconds. At this modern technology, it is very, very, very easy. So once when the information reaches to the people, what do they do? They will take stern measures, which are nothing but precautions. Some will suggest to stay safe in the houses, or build baka houses, etc. So ultimately, they will come to a conclusion to isolate this region. So when once they isolate this region, it becomes sensitive, right?
So you may get the doubt that how can we calculate the wind speed with the help of a windmill. So actually this is a motor. It is a 12 volt DC motor. It has 150 RPM. If we give 12 volts to this motor, it rotates at the 150 RPM. So when we attach a propeller to it, with the help of wind speed, the propeller rotates. The electric DC generator principally, it converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. So we are storing electrical energy produced by with the help of a high voltage batteries. And we are checking the voltage rate.
As the voltage rating changes.
As the windmill rotates, the voltage we can check here. It's getting 5, 6, it's not stable. So for every 10 seconds we are taking the samples of this voltage and we are taking average. So when we average these voltage values, if we provide 12 volts to this DC motor, it rotates at 150 RPM. If the average is 10, where for 12 volts is 150 range, for 10, how much we are calculating by multiplication?
You may get it out. So we are alerting people. So what time we have to alert? We have only speed of the cyclone, or we didn't have the distance as well as the time taken. So here we mentioned that boundary of the region. So we are mentioning that we are calculating boundary from the region. From the region only we are taking boundaries, right? So based on that we are dividing India into number of states. So obviously we have the distance, distance time, distance and speed. And we can obviously calculate the time, right? So due to that people will become really isolated. So when the cyclone comes to this region, it destroys everything and the cyclone is over. So here the new chapter begins. People again come to the native places, right? So as it is the native place, they can't leave it. So once they come, they want to reconstruct and remodel their infrastructure and build the buildings and so much. It costs millions of dollars. So once it is completed, for running of the modern machinery, what we are using now, it requires electricity. For constructing and remodeling this only, millions of dollars has been spent. So this will begin. This will become a big burden for them. So whatever the we already discussed that windmills are placed here. So when the cyclone comes, due to that wind force, the propeller of the windmill rotates, and this energy is converted to electricity, which is stored in high voltage batteries.
So what the electricity which we store with them when the cyclone occurs, the same electricity we are sending to the region. So they need to pay the electricity bills. So that electricity which is provided to them is produced with the help of cyclone. Even though they lost their property, they are getting electricity. So we can reduce the property loss with the help of this.
No, the cyclone is causing destruction, also produce electricity which they are using now.
This is our idea. We can use windmills for this purpose also.
Thank you.
Thank you.